The queen excluder is one of those pieces of beekeeping equipment that's named for what it does. It excludes queens. In this particular case, I have a queen excluder on top of this deep box. Let's pretend, for example, that it was full of bees. This box here, this medium super is full of bees. And I want, with this excluder, to keep the queen somewhere. In this particular case, if the queen is in this lowermost box, the deep box, and I add this excluder, she will be unable to go up through the excluder into this medium box or medium super. So I know that if she's here and I put this excluder on the hive, she remains there. Likewise, if I remove this excluder and put these two boxes together, then the queen has free reign between these two boxes. So how does that work? Well, as I've turned up this excluder here, you'll see that excluders are composed of hard, stiff wires that are spaced such that the queen is too large to go through, but that the worker bees themselves can pass. So essentially, by putting this on, you're still allowing the free movement of workers through this excluder, but you're trapping the queen either above or below the excluder, wherever she was when you inserted this excluder. So a lot of beekeepers like this management tool because they can know roughly where their queen is in the nest. There are some exceptions. If the wires on a queen excluder are damaged and they're opened, then the queen might be able to find that opening and pass through it. But if it's in good condition, you can put the queen excluder on the hive and trust that she is either above it or below it, wherever you trapped her. Now let me spend a little bit of time introducing you to the three types of excluders that you can use on your hives. Excluders tend to be named after what their border is. And so in this particular case, while it is a metal excluder, it has a wooden boundary, so this would be a wooden bound queen excluder. And when I was growing up as a beekeeper, I loved this. To me, this is the old school excluder type. I loved it, it was on all of my colonies, but it has a few drawbacks. Drawback number one, the border is wooden. And while I like that from an old school perspective, when you are using your hive tool in the corner, when rain is hitting this excluder, it's going to rot. The edges get damaged, the corners get damaged, the wooden frame around it rots. I don't like that. The second thing I don't like about it from a practical standpoint, I know it's hard to notice, but the fact that it has a wide wooden border means the wire frame is elevated slightly above the top bars of the frames beneath it. And this space is larger than bee space. And when you put the medium super in this case on top of this wooden bound queen excluder, the same is true from the metal wire to the bottom of the frames here. Bee space is violated both between the frames and the metal excluder from the top and between the metal excluder and the frames from the bottom. So why is that an issue? Well, when I use wooden bound excluders, I tend to see bees build a lot of burr comb above the excluder attached to it, as well as below the excluder attached to the frames. So much burr comb, in fact, that the bees may store honey in the burr comb, queens may lay eggs in the cells, and so anytime you're taking this excluder off and out of these boxes, you might have stuff you want to deal with that you don't really want to deal with. So while it's a nice excluder and it's something I've used a lot in the past, I use it less now for those two major drawbacks. The second type of excluder overcomes the rot factor associated with a wooden bound excluder, but it also has some drawbacks. That excluder is the plastic queen excluder. It's so simple to use. It's also comparatively cheap. And furthermore, the rain's not going to bother it. So it is a really good option, but it almost violates bee space the other way. If the wooden excluder makes too much bee space, the plastic excluder can make too little. And what you'll find is the plastic will sag in the middle and touch the top bar of the frames, or these frames in the uppermost box. If it goes this way, it might touch the bottom of those frames. And so you can get propolis stuck everywhere. So one of the benefits is weatherproof. They tend to be sturdy, but gosh, they can be aggravating because of the propolis use. So it's something you should give a try if you're interested in it, but I kind of consider it a lot like this wooden bound queen excluder. It does its job, but it's not my favorite. So let's talk about my favorite. My favorite happens to be the metal-bound queen excluder. It's also a metal queen excluder, but unlike the wood-bound queen excluder, it has metal on the edges. When you put it on, it's a lot sturdier than the plastic excluder. It doesn't have that wooden frame, so it's not going to rot at the joints, and so it can take a lot more hive tool torque, a lot more weight. It can take rain exposure, etc. So that's a really nice feature of this metal excluder. To me, the best bang for your buck tends to be this metal-bound excluder, and we use those a lot here in our lab at the University of Florida. Let me talk a little bit about the appropriate use of queen excluders. Now, this harkens back to what strategy you're going to use for your hive configuration. Are you going to use double deeps, single deeps, triple mediums, whatever you use? In this particular example, I'm going to use a deep brood box as my brood chamber. A medium super is a honey super. That's the honey for the bees. That's going to be my standard configuration. In this context, I don't want the queen laying eggs up in this super that has honey that's available for the bees. So I will find the queen and place her in this lowermost box. This is going to be the brood chamber. I place the queen excluder here. I tend to go opposite corners, diagonal corners, and use my fingers to make sure that excluder is flush on the edges of the box. And then I can take that uppermost super and put it on top like so. So in this configuration, the queen is trapped in this bottom box. She cannot go through the excluder, and only the workers will be able to come up here. And I like this standard hive configuration. Again, a lot of folks don't like it. They might want to use triple mediums or double deeps, etc. A lot of beekeepers don't even like to use excluders because they will claim that they are honey excluders, that the worker bees don't like to carry nectar and store it up here. That's not true. There are a few reasons I would tell you not to use an excluder, but it has nothing to do with honey production. The first reason is maybe you just don't want to buy another thing to have to put in your beehive. It's not necessary. It's just a convenient thing to allow you to know where your queen is. So that's one reason I wouldn't use an excluder. Another reason I might not use an excluder is if I want to give queens more space to lay eggs. But even then, if I were going to give her two boxes to lay eggs, I might put the excluder above this box and stack my supers for honey production on top of that. One thing that you need to remember is not only are queen excluders queen excluders, but they are also drone excluders. Drone honeybees cannot go up and down through that excluder. So you have to be mindful of that, because if drones ever try to navigate that queen excluder, they may get stuck trying to go up through it and they can die. You'll see that a lot. And then the question that I get every winter is, what do I do with my excluders during winter? And here's my advice here. Now, in a winter setting, if you're using a queen excluder, it's very common for the honey to be stored here and for the cluster in this bottom box to want to migrate up as winter progresses, as those bees migrate to the next available honey. Well, if that cluster moves through the excluder into this uppermost box, that excluder will actually trap the queen in the bottom box, so the cluster may leave her en route to this uppermost box. A lot of folks say that doesn't happen, but I've experienced it myself, even here in Florida where the weather doesn't get that cold. So every year, as winter is progressing, I will go into my hives, remove the super, take off the queen excluder, and return the super to the brood chamber. In this case, that cluster can now migrate up into the super, the queen can go with them, and everything is good. Now, a lot of beekeepers, me in the past as well, will take that excluder back to their shop, and when spring rolls around, they'll come back and want to move their queen back to the lowermost box, but they forgot the excluder. So one more trick that I will tell you with regard to winter use of excluders is, when I take off the excluders in early winter, I tend to store them on the hive immediately up under the lid, like so. And now my excluders are under the lid, ready for me when I come back in late winter. And what triggers that? Well, I will see certain types of plants blooming in my area. The bees are bringing in pollen, they're producing brood, and then I go, aha, it's probably going to be warm enough in the coming weeks and months for me not to worry about the queen anymore. I'll go into my hive, find the queen in this upper super, return her to what I want to be the brood box, My excluder's under the lid. I put the excluder back here, return the super, and I've restored my standard year-long configuration using that excluder. Excluders are not for everyone, but if you find them convenient to use, don't be talked out of it. One of the reasons I like using excluders so much is because I like knowing where my queen is. I like knowing which box she's going to inhabit. I like being able to manage her. Not every beekeeper is that way. Make beekeeping yours. If you like excluders, use them. If you don't like excluders, don't. But a few pointers that I've shared in this video, I hope will help you use them appropriately. The most important tip that I can give you is make sure and take them off over winter so that the queen doesn't get trapped in the bottom box. And now you know you can store those just up under the lid for use when you go back and restore that excluder in spring. Happy beekeeping.